Welcome to this video where I'll show you how to connect a PS2 mouse to an Amiga with an Arduino. Disclaimer, I am not a professional electronics engineer. This tutorial is based on my personal experience. If you reproduce the actions presented in this video, it's at your own risk. Here are the components I used. An Arduino, a compatible PS2 USB mouse with the PS2 adapter, a DB9 female connector, a PS2 female connector. I bought my Arduino with a starter kit including many components and in a particular a solderless breadboard, colored wires, a resistor and a LED. I downloaded the Arduino project from Quantum Cross GitHub where you can find the source code meegamouse. This project requires the PS2 library but the link in the source code isn't working. I found it in the Arduino playground. You'll get all the links in the description of this video. I've saved the two zip files in the same directory. First, unzip the meegamouse file. Then move the .ino file in the meegamouse directory. You can delete the empty folder. The author specifies you need to change a line in the ps2.h file. To do so, unzip the ps2.zip file, then go in the ps2 folder and open the ps2.h file with a text editor. Change in the include line wprogram.h to arduino.h. Save and close the editor. Create a zip file with the PS2 folder and replace the original file. In the Arduino Manager, in the Sketch menu, select Include Library, then Add Zip Library. Find your ps2.zip file and open it. You can find now in the Sketch menu, in the Include Library submenu, the ps2 library. You don't need to click it, because it's already included in the project. Now you can open the meegamouse.ino project. Don't forget to set the right type of your Arduino board. Compile the code and upload it to your Arduino. I have a broken Amiga mouse, so I opened it and I got the cable. I connected to it the colored wires from my starter kit. I got an old PS2 cable with a female connector. I've cut it and removed the insulation from the wires. I've soldered a bit the end of the cables to make it stronger in order to plug them into the solderless breadboard. On the schema, you can see the pin numbers of each connectors. This is what they are used for. I only use the female connectors. To find out which wire is used for each pin, I've plugged every wire of the female PS2 socket to the breadboard. Let's see how it works. Inside, there are two rows with 63 connectors. So everything you plug in the same vertical line will be connected. There are also four horizontal connectors, which I don't use here. I've made a small circuit with a LED and a resistor to prevent it from burning. I only use the power block of the Arduino by connecting the blue wire to the ground and the yellow one to the plus 5 volts. Let's see if it works. Yes! I've assigned a color wire from my starter kit to each wire from the socket. By connecting the pin to the LED, I can see if the current flows. When the LED is lit, it means you've got the right pin. I can now find the pin of each wire. In the Amiga mouse code, you can see which pins you have to connect from the cables on the left to the pins on the digital block on the Arduino on the right. We will also need to connect the power pins. Now I've put my color wires to the cables and I'll test every pin of both PS2 and DB9 cables. I've noted the color of each pin on the schema. My old Amiga mouse didn't have a middle button, so I ignored the pin number 5 on the DB9. Let's see how the wiring should look like for the PS2 side. As you see, I added it plus 5 volts and the ground. Let's make the connections. Now the DB9 wires. In addition of the pins described in the source code, you'll need to connect the pin number 8 to the ground. You could also connect the pin number 7 to the plus 5 volts, which would enable the Amiga to feed the Arduino and the PS2 mouse without external power supply for the Arduino, but I wouldn't recommend it. It can be dangerous. Let's make the connections. And let's plug the mouse in the Arduino in the Amiga, the power supply in the Arduino. The LED blinks when it boots, then stays on. If there is a problem with one connection, the LED will keep blinking. Now let's see if it works. The movement of the cursor is smooth with a tiny delay. Both left and right buttons work. So here it is, I hope you liked this video and that it was helpful. Thank you for watching and see you next time!